my YouTube channel, and in this video we are going to discuss about multilevel inverter. To know what is multilevel inverter and why there is a necessity of multilevel, firstly we need to know what is an inverter. So I'll give you a brief explanation about inverter. Inverter is a basic circuit that converts DC power to AC power at rated voltage and frequency. At required voltage and frequency. That is, if you give DC power at the input, you will be getting AC power, that is alternating current. Okay, that is, for example, if I am giving a DC voltage, that is unidirectional, okay, DC voltage at the input to the inverter circuit, then I will be getting a sinusoidal waveform at the output. In the ideal case, here sinusoidal waveform is in the ideal case because that's what we are using in our day-to-day lives. So basically, this inverter is called to be as DC to AC converter. Okay, practically, it is very difficult to obtain ideal sinusoidal waveform at the output. Let me show you why. Let us consider a conventional topology. Topology is nothing but the way you connect the switches, the source and the load in a circuit. So this is an H-bridge topology. Suppose if I'm giving source VDC at the input and I'm operating these two switches, say S1 and S2, then what happens is the current flows in the direction showed here in pink color. Yes, you can see that in this way. Say if we consider this point as A and this point as B, then this positive terminal of the source is connected to the point A of the load and negative terminal is connected to the B because it is in this way. That is positive to A and negative to B. Let it be aside. And the waveform, the current will be in this direction. Say in this way. Here you can see that VDC is connected in this way, A, B, plus and minus. Here you can see that the positive terminal is connected to the A and negative is connected to B. That is VDC, positive VDC is being obtained at the output. So this is plus V. Now, in the second half cycle, say if I'm operating these two switches, S3 and S4, what happens is the current flows in the direction showed in blue color in the circuit. That is in this way. That is, now the current is flowing in this direction and you can also see that the positive terminal of the source is now being connected to point B. That is in this way. This is B and this is A. See, the positive is being connected to B. That is plus to B and negative to A. Now you can see that VDC is now being applied in this way. That is in the opposite direction to the previous one. Now the obtained waveform is in this way. That is minus V. That is minus at A and positive at B. Okay, now this explains that the obtained output waveform is not sinusoidal. Of course, it is symmetrical. That means it is having equal magnitude in both the directions. That is, it is alternating current waveform, but still it is not sinusoidal waveform. You know that this is the obtained waveform. But what is the desired? Desired waveform is a sinusoidal waveform and it will be in this way. And you can say that there is a deviation from the desired waveform to the obtained waveform. That is, see, the desired value is this, but obtained value is this. Desired value is this, obtained value is this. That is, throughout the waveform, there is a deviation in the output waveform. And this deviation is undesirable. This deviation is calculated and is given a name called THD, that is total harmonic distortion. According to the IEEE standards, the value of THD must be less than 5% for any kind of topology that you select. So before designing any multi-level inverter, the first thing you must keep in your mind is the THD must be less than 5%. Whatever the cost of the circuit, whatever may be the complexity of the circuit, everything stands next to the THD value. Otherwise, it is not accepted. So in order to limit this THD to less than 5%, we are going for multi-level. The term multi-level inverter starts from three-level inverter. Here you can see that the waveform has two levels, that is plus VDC and minus VDC. So this is a basic conventional one. It is having two levels. So if you consider some other circuit like this, see here, you're having plus V, zero and minus V. This is a three-level inverter. And here you can see that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are six levels, so this is called a six-level inverter. As we are going for higher and higher levels, the distortion will be less. Let me show you how. Say, consider this waveform. This is called a stepped waveform or a staircase waveform just because of its appearance. And this sinusoidal waveform is the desired waveform. And you can see that this is the deviation now. Here, this is the deviation. As we are going for higher levels, this deviation will be less. Let me show you a few more examples. This is a 9-level inverter. That is, it is having 9 levels. That is positive and negative. All together, there are 9 levels. And this is a 25-level multi-level inverter. That is, it is having 25 levels. That is, the positive maximum is plus 12 VDC and the negative maximum is minus 12 VDC. And together, it's called 25-level multi-level inverter. You can observe that as we have gone to higher levels, this obtained waveform is almost nearer to the desired sinusoidal waveform. And let me show you something else. 49-level multi-level inverter, that is, it is almost same like that of a sinusoidal waveform. And if you obtain the FFT analysis of these circuits, then it will be like this. Here, this is the output waveform. This is for a 9-level multi-level inverter and this shows the THD. That is, you can see that here this first thing is fundamental harmonic, that is first harmonic, or it's the main thing. And this is third harmonic, fifth harmonic, seventh, ninth, 11th, so on. Of course, you already know that the even harmonics are eliminated for a symmetrical waveform. And for the 9-level multi-level inverter, the THD obtained is 5.37%, which is not at all within IEEE standards. So if we go for a higher level multi-level inverter, what we obtain is this. This is a FFT analysis of 49-level multi-level inverter. The THD obtained is 0.42%, which is much better than the desired value, that is less than 5%. So as we go for higher and higher levels, the THD will be reduced. But the problem is the cost increases because the number of devices implemented in the topology increases and the complexity will be increasing. So it is very much required to be very careful while designing a multi-level inverter. I hope you understood basically what a multi-level inverter is, and if you have any more doubts, you can comment down in the comment section. And if you like this video, give a thumbs up and you can share it with your friends. Thank you for watching.